Hey everybody, welcome back. In this video, we're talking about the basics of automatic exposure control, also called AEC. AECs were developed to provide x-ray images with consistent receptor exposure, regardless of the patient size or tissue density. The AEC works by controlling the exposure time. The machine automatically adjusts the exposure time up or down to ensure the detector receives the correct receptor exposure. In other words, AEC takes the guessing out of setting the mass, because the time and the total mass is determined by the AEC. They also help to reduce the chance of overexposing patients during the procedures. To get the best radiograph, the image receptor needs to be exposed to just the right amount of radiation. But setting the correct technique depends on a huge number of variables, like the patient's size, the anatomy of interest, tissue density, pathology, SID, OID, collimation, and many, many more. The name of automatic exposure control tells us exactly what it does. The automatic exposure control makes sure the receptor gets exactly the right amount of exposure. So how does it work? During a procedure, the KVP and the MA are set by the operator, but the AEC system sets the exposure time and therefore controls the total mass. When an exposure is initiated, x-rays begin flowing through the patient towards the image receptor. The AEC system includes an ionization chamber, which is a gas-filled cavity used to measure radiation. The ionization chamber is between the patient and the receptor within the table or Wallbucky assembly. Once the ionization chamber measures the appropriate amount of exposure, the AEC system sends a signal to the exposure timer and stops the exposure. The ionization chamber is a very important part of the AEC system. Most systems have three small chambers rather than one large chamber. Sometimes these chambers are called AEC cells, and depending on the part being imaged, you can choose to activate one or two or all three of the chambers. Some systems have more than three, but they work in exactly the same way. AEC cells are also sometimes called photo timers or simply radiation detectors. Some AEC systems use solid-state photoconductors rather than ionization chambers, but they accomplish the same thing. Think of these ionization chambers as buckets. These chambers collect radiation during the exposure, and once the bucket is full, the exposure shuts off. Again, this is important because exposure times can vary widely depending on the patient's size. For small patients and small parts, the AEC system will shut down the exposure sooner. That results in a shorter exposure time and a lower mass, which is exactly what we want for a smaller patient. For larger patients and larger parts, the AEC system will extend the exposure time a little longer. That results in a longer exposure time and a larger mass, and that's exactly what we want for larger patients and larger parts. So this is what happens during the exposure. Once an exposure is initiated, it continues until the ionization chambers have detected the correct level of exposure to create a good image, and then the exposure is terminated. For every patient, the bucket is the same size, because the receptor exposure needed for a good image is the same. However, smaller patients absorb less radiation, so the buckets fill up fast and the exposure shuts off sooner. Average-sized patients absorb more radiation, so the bucket takes a little longer to fill. Large patients absorb even more radiation, so the bucket takes even longer to fill. This is all controlled by the ionization chambers. In order for the AEC system to work correctly, you have to select the correct cells and position the patient correctly over the cells. The part of interest should always be placed directly over the ionization chamber. Here's an example of something that could go wrong. When performing a lateral C-spine, the C-spine is, of course, the part of interest, so it should be centered directly over the center AEC cell. When the center cell is activated, the C-spine will be perfectly exposed and well demonstrated in the radiograph. A common mistake is to center anterior to the spine with the soft tissues of the neck over the AEC cell. This results in a perfect exposure of the soft tissues of the neck, but underexposure of the spine. Comparing these images side by side, the importance of correct positioning is quite obvious. This is also why it's very important to activate the correct AEC cells. For different body parts, it's different. For a chest x-ray, you would activate the outer two cells over the lung fields. The lungs are the primary organs of interest on a chest x-ray, so we want to make sure that they are exposed to just the right amount of radiation. For a thoracic spine, you would activate only the center cell under the thoracic spine. We want a good exposure of the spine, not the lungs. For the abdomen, you would use all three cells. This ensures that the entire abdomen is correctly exposed. In addition to proper cell selection, another key consideration is lead shielding placement. Lead shielding should never be placed over any portion of an active ionization chamber. This would slow down the flow of x-rays into the cell and significantly increase the exposure time and increase the patient dose. So in summary, the purpose of AEC is to control the exposure by automatically adjusting the exposure time. Correct use of AEC requires correct patient positioning, correct ionization cell selection, and correct shielding placement. If you enjoyed this video, I encourage you to visit cloverlearning.com and explore our robust selection of video-based courses, certification exam prep question banks, and continuing education resources. Lastly, please remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you can stay up to date on our latest videos.